Now, before I throw open the discussion to our panelists, let me quickly go back across to Rika. Rika, you've covered IPL now for 6 seasons. What do you think Guru's role was? Do you think he was a passive member or was he really active with the Chennai Super Kings?
Nikhil, I will put it down in simple words. You and I are also cricket enthusiasts. Mr. Srinivasan wouldn't give us $6 million to go to an auction and splurge on a player, which Mr. Gurunath Mayappan had the privilege of doing on Ravindra Jadeja in the 2012 auctions. It was his decision to buy Ravindra Jadeja for $6 million. Of course, $4 million was on secret ballot, which went, the money went to IPL. Besides that, we've shown our viewers conclusive evidences of how, of what kind of involvement he had with the team, either as a, you can call it owner, you can call it principal, but at the end of the day, he was a hands-on owner. He was always with the team, attending to their needs, looking after them. In fact, all the time that we have seen him, we found Gurunath being with the team in the dugout, strategizing with Mahendra Singh Dhoni. In fact, one of the things I can tell you about Mr. Gurunath is that he never used to sit down during the match. He's a superstitious man. He used to keep standing behind in the dugout, and all through the match he used to be there. So we have seen Mr. Gurunath all through these 6 seasons. Of course, in the first season he wasn't that prominent, but ever since South Africa, he's always been with the team.
Rika Roy, thanks so much for that update. Let's start the discussion now with our four panelists, and I'll start with Sunny Bhai, who joins us live from Calcutta. We'll get into the role of Gurunath a little later in the discussion, but firstly, I believe the BCCI has already set up an inquiry commission to look into the matter. But my question to you is, do you think that they can really probe this matter fairly, considering, you know, it's, they're looking into the son-in-law of the BCCI president, the matter concerns him?
Why are you doubting them? You're doubting their credibility, you're doubting their honesty, you're doubting their integrity even before they have started their deliberations. I don't think that's fair. I think we should just wait. We should be patient. I know we are in the age of T20 where everything is instant and we want, you know, everything to be done in about 2 or 3 hours. But a situation like this, I think it might be prudent for all of us to be just a little bit patient. The commission will give its report and then maybe we can discuss that.